I just want to do something that takes me out of my comfort zone. I've never done paddleboarding before, water sports in general, kind of not done it, and I just want to see how I do. That's pretty much it.
I think that most of them are going to have a rude awakening because we've been doing most of the stand-up paddleboarding events on closed water environments, so like lakes or ocean inlets where there's not a lot of waves. And you can tell there's not big waves out there right now, but there's enough, you know, lateral instability that I think it's going to be a rude awakening for them. They're going to feel great, but it's going to really challenge them because nothing we do in the gym can simulate that shifting of, you know, being back and forth on the water. So it might add a different dynamic to their training. I know myself personally, I love adding water to the training that I do because it adds a completely different and uncontrollable environment. You got the difference in temperature, like I said, the stability stuff. It just adds a cool aspect to it. So hopefully it'll add a little bit to their training and give them some insight into how well their training is actually going. Because they've been doing that stuff in the gym, now they can apply it to something outside and hopefully notice the difference in how they feel.
Here to paddleboard. Like I said, I've never done it before and I am kind of nervous about it. I want to stay on the board. I'm going to stay as close to the shore as possible without looking like a wimp. And it's a good thing I have, you know, friends out here that can pull me out if I'm, you know, counting 1, 2, 3. So, I see one of my buddies coming out now. So, I just want to try it, man. If I do this, this will be a big deal for me.
You know, the water's interesting. It covers a large percentage of the earth, and a lot of people don't feel comfortable in the water. So, if you have a lot of experience in the water, throwing a paddleboarding event in there is not going to be a big deal. If you fall off the board, no big deal. You're just going to go swim and pick up the board. However, if you only swim in pools or you don't have that much water experience, it's going to add a little bit more of that fear component.
We're going to do a WOD though. On your wave, you'll go to the start point. We'll start you. You're going to go around the flag. Back in, you'll do a sumo deadlift high pull. Once you finish those, you're going to head back out, hit the flag, come back around. You're going to do 50 kettlebell swings, okay? Once you finish those, go out, hop on a board, come back in. You'll get a time, we'll post your name up on the board, have some fun, have a good time.
So out here in the water, we have Dan and Ben who can't swim. So today's their first day really getting in the open water. So they're taking a huge risk, which is great to see them do. And because they're not strong swimmers, we have people out there that are making sure that, you know, they're comfortable and they're confident and having an awesome first experience.
Hey man, done nothing like this ever in my life. It's good to do something different. Came close to overcoming the fear today, fear of the water. I feel good.
Yeah, I went out with Ben Taylor, just to help him out a little bit, steady him on the board. It's part of the introducing the new sports and all that good stuff. It's hard to, if you're not used to it, to get used to doing that, but he did well.
You know, growing up as a kid, never learned to swim. Grew up in the urban area, just was no facility to accommodate that. When you get to adulthood, it just becomes not a priority for you. Certainly one thing that CrossFit has done for me is made me feel like I should be expanding my horizons. And that's what this was for me today. It's, you know, I only went out a little bit, but that was, trust me. I had my friend help me. Other folks push me. it's just a good experience. You know, something I wouldn't have done. I'm getting a little. Something I wouldn't have done otherwise. So, you know, the water is a big fear for me. So, it feels good to have gotten out there and have people support you, do something you've never done before. So that's what the community CrossFit does.
You may not become a competitive swimmer out of it, but you need to be confident and honestly able to, your father, you know, you need to be able to save yourself.
Right.
and save your kids, if God forbid, because even though your kids are great swimmers, my kids are great swimmers too, yeah. But you know, it's our parental responsibility.
Absolutely.
So, but that's good. I mean, I'm proud of you for getting out there.
Yeah.
And you're giving it a shot. I mean, you went farther out than.
Yeah. I mean, it was scary. I mean, if Scott wasn't
better,
there, I felt good that it was my friend.
Right.
You know what I mean? I have more confidence in what he can do than what I can do. So he was. If he hadn't been there, I wouldn't have done it.
When you finish swim lessons, like when you go through, when you're good, hit me up. I want to hear about it.
All right.
That'll be exciting. I want to see it. Like, send us in a video.
Yeah, I will.
Like that.
I will. That'd be cool. Trouble.